Hey Scorpio, how are you? I'm Mary Ellen. Welcome if you're new. It's wonderful to have you here, and if you're a returning viewer, thank you. I love having the tribe, my guides call it, come and pick up their messages. I'm a clairvoyant channel. My job in this life, or this sector of time, is to transmit some messages, channel through, from source energy, a group of guides, if you will. The things that you need to know if you are seriously on your life path and trying to understand your personhood, your mission, your purpose, all those things. So we take a look at some oracle cards to understand the energy that you're floating in every particular month. And we're going to look into your destiny. What is your life path given all the energy you have available to you? What's going on with your light codes? What about your DNA codes? How is that affected in your life by what's going on with your soul trajectory? So Scorpio, for you in the month of July, look at that. Numerologically, it's a 9. If you don't know what that means, go and look it up online. It's powerful. You're at the end of a cycle. You're coming to the top of your particular form of energy. My guys just said audit. Interesting, we'll see what comes out. To prepare to start a new journey. You're in the last stage of something. So Lizard is about going into the dream time. And I can assure you, looking at the cards that have come out, that's exactly what's happening. I love this for you, Scorpio. It's correctly in line with your energy. My guides are talking about your ancient glyph and the meaning, the purpose, the experience of Scorpio energy. Very mysterious. Very out into the universe. And I'm not talking about being a space cadet. I'm talking about your connection with source energy and the divine. You are going to have a journey with you, and you are going to be witnessing your transformation this month as this comes forward. And the new journey is going to come. That adds up to a 10. Something very new coming forward by the end of the month for you. And you're going to be using your sacred vision, which you have, Scorpio, in spades, just to accompany yourself, to witness your transformation, your movement forward into your destiny. And the place you're going to travel through, of course, because you're a water sign, is the heart chakra. Look at that. Beautiful. Enlivening, opening, carrying forward in a very gentle way. That's what the deer energy is about. So quite a beautiful journey for you this month. The theme that my guides want to speak about with you is the journey. This is the moon card, of course. In this deck, the Celtic Wisdom Tarot, if you don't have a copy, try to get one. It's not in print anymore, but it's a powerful deck. So the imaginer of harmony. You can get in that boat. Pay attention to the moon cycles in the month of July. You'll put your hands on the oars and sail away to any place that you can imagine out in the dream time of your own prophecy, your own life, your own energy code. There is something that you carry within you. So go straight through the heart chakra into this beautiful dream time. For this incredible journey, it's going to bring things to illumination. It will bring things to the surface that have been inaccessible within you. That's what you're going to be witnessing. And it's going to bring culmination to this phase of your journey. It's beautiful in every single way. So when you go out into the dream time through your heart chakra, and because it's so mystical, you may actually be having some dream time journeys, astral travel, visions, because you, my darlings, look at that. You see yourself? The guardian of truth, the guardian of the gateway. That is the high priestess. That's where you're going. You're going to walk through a portal. You're going to be given access to the temple of the high priestess, who sits with the full moon in her crown and the new moon at her feet, holding the sacred scrolls of all wisdom. Because of your energy, Scorpio, and you're so filled with this type of, and my guides are talking about in the old days, they used to call it occult knowledge. This is the energy that you carry for the benefit of yourself and all the rest of us here. You provide the astrology wheel with that very needed element. You're going straight through. Where do you see this card spread? So in your human life, what's the point? What's the purpose of going into the dream time while you're here, incarnated in physical form? That's the point. That's the star card. Look at you, mind melding with the universe. You really are going way out, way deep out. And you're dreaming, the sacred dreamer of growth. You're dreaming about your destiny. This is a moment of destiny, so both things are true. That's why the guides are giving you the advice. Witness yourself, keep a journal, I think. Write some things down, keep a notepad by your bed. If you pass through the month of July and you don't have any dreamtime journeys, astral travel, downloads, visions, etc., or just moments of epiphany, brilliance, literally. Write those down. Those things are going to be utilized in your life going forward as you manifest your destiny and grow your life into the experience that you want. I love that for you. So part of what you're wanting, part of what you're going to experience is coming into your wisdom time, maturity. That's another major arcana. That's the Hermit card. So this is, my guides are saying it's giving a nod to that part of your life that you live that is separate from society. All wisdom holders do. They hold themselves apart a little bit. For a Scorpio, it's an ongoing journey. So you probably take downtime, alone time. You're a little secretive. It's not really about secrets. It's about this. The beautiful energy requires some solitude. The knowledge that you carry, pardon me, requires some solitude, some downtime. So take your space if you need it, especially if you suddenly have an epiphany or dreamtime journeys, all the things I've been saying. Provide this to yourself and understand that's what's going to happen when you go out for this journey into the dream time. There's a prophecy that's waiting. You're going to go and collect it, I believe. The revelation of art, the Nine of Cups. When you have these experiences going through the month of July, it's going to bring you a lot of self happiness, self satisfaction, wish fulfillment, all the kinds of things that are associated with Nine of Cups energy. So this is, you see the jewel-encrusted barrel of water? When you travel out, you're going into that realm, the realm of prophecy that the universe brings forward, the destiny that's already written in the stars, my guides are saying, those kinds of notions. So as you walk through your human life in the month of July, this is the third application, my guides are saying, of this energy. The liberator of devotion. That's the death card. Your card, Scorpio. Your earthly energy, your incarnation is ripe for a journey in deep into your Scorpio energy. That's where you're going. And it's going to happen because of the astrology I carry. I cover that up because YouTube doesn't like it. So to see how shamanic this journey is going to be, spiritual death and rebirth, by going straight in to the dream time, literally, of your sacred energy. Look at you, Scorpio. Woo! It's giving me a chill. It's phenomenal. Straight out through the heart chakra of a Scorpio, which is a very mystical, powerful place to be standing. Or traveling through, my guides are saying, as the case may be. There's a lot of chatter going on about you in my head. So, Scorpio, when you have this moment of destiny, my guides are using the plural. So, this is going to be an ongoing process. You're going to be shamanically carried into the very deep of your own energy. your own glyph. If you're not really familiar with it, go study it up in preparation, okay? So your devotion will be liberated and you will be set free. That's what this reading is ultimately all about, and the importance of witnessing your journey on a soul level. So here we have the human experience, that deep major arcana, with another major arcana's shamanic vision and journey, propelling the energy, connecting the energy between your human experience and your soul's intention. And here's what it is. More water energy. The chariot card, the mover of energy. There we see more reflections of the High Priestess, the Great Mother, the sacred realm, the universe, the Scorpio energy, new growth coming forward. In terms of the way this journey reflects, hang on one sec, sorry, reflects and repeats. My guides are saying, like a chord, like notes in a chord. The purpose of your, my guides just said soul dedication. Whatever you came here to contemplate, to experience, to create, my God, okay, here's what's coming through. To create the template of the vibration that will propel you forward into your next soul journey, because it is coming. You are finishing something. The Moon card is here. The Dreamer of Growth is here. On a soul level, you're feeling it emotionally in your life, psychologically, all the things I already said about dreams and visions. And look at that, it's the Ace of Cups. That is Semias, the chanting one. She is chanting about upon the sacred cauldron, the bowl of all creation. The augury is a prophecy. The augury of art, factors of Venus, water energy, truth, love, purity, the arts, abundance, the flow of all those things into your life. This is what the culmination of your soul journey that you're leaving behind to start a new one is for. You get a brand new start. And you get to understand and experience your energy so much so that your cup literally overflows with this new energy you're being given into the water element of your life and your heart chakra. Amazing. Because that's where we started. Don't forget. Some kind of healing on heart chakra level. So I say it every month, but please go watch all of your sister signs. Watch Cancer. The Cancer life path and love readings blew my mind in June and now also in July. That, as a cardinal sign, affects you. And your set point will vibrate in its own placement in response to what the cardinal sign is doing. Go look. Massive healing upon the earth. So there you are. The elopement of battle, Eight of Swords. You're inside this dream time, your, all right, my guys are telling me I said it wrong, your time inside this dream time that filled you with anxiety, this journey that you've been having on a soul level that reflected into your life, you're being released into the light. There's nothing that's going to be holding you back, nothing that's going to hem you in or give you a preset definition about your being. It's an interesting story about a man who went into the dream time. Thank you, Spirit. And about the adventures that he had there. The problems that he had, the problems that he caused. He was there for a long time. I think it's a little bit of Rip Van Winkle kind of thing, like 20 years or something, stuck in the dream time having this adventure. And while in there, he angered a lot of people, women. He found himself in a village, and he started having sex with all the women of the village. who knows, some kind of bizarre male fantasy experience. But basically, they finally just circled him and whipped him to wake him up so these deeds would not be able to be repeated, because he was violating people by playing games. So whatever, however that resonates in your own life, just understand, even if it's just difficulties that you've been having trying to imagine your life or trying to change your life, they're going to be over. You're leaving them behind. In the month of July, you're going to be released into the light. I love this. It's perfect for you. And right on schedule, of course, a new soul journey. So I just want to point out something. Do you see all those vessels? There's that vessel. There's that healing bowl, vessel, whatever you want to call it. Look at this card. Whoops, wrong way. Do you see how you're going to be walking out? You're going to be walking out back into the dream time. Okay, correctly ordered. The mystical part of your life had like a kink in it, something. And you have lived through the challenges in this particular lifetime that created. And my guides are using these cards, not so much because of the story, but because of the allegory, okay? So don't get stuck. A, don't ever get stuck on gender. B, don't ever get stuck on the technical meaning of a card. That's why reading is an art, because you have to be able to understand, well, what does that mean in relation to everything else? It just means you're about to be released. You are going to manifest your release. You will do it. I love this, because you're going through the gateway deep into your own nature in order to be liberated from some challenge all the way into the Scorpio deep. Oof, drop me some comments. I want to hear about that adventure. I actually have a Scorpio in my eighth house because I have what's called a pure chart, because I'm an Aries rising. So I understand this. In some way, I've been living through it myself. So a new soul journey coming forward. Take a look at that. Just see the destiny's turning. And what you're doing is you're walking out into the universe to seek the sacred bowl of healing, of renewal, the Akashic records. You're going deep into the soul dream time to retrieve something. And it has everything to do with you and the wisdom that you carry. When you come in as a Scorpio, you're kind of already there. And then you have to develop and develop and develop under the prism of your particular energy, which gives you a certain flavor of understanding, right? So now you're going out through this portal in all the ways that we see you going through a portal. Look, it's all over your reading, all over, literally, almost every card, indicating some piece of that journey, some part of your desire, some piece of your power, if you will, your ability. So, Kundalini awakening, perhaps, to turn destiny and go back to the source energy out of which you came. The reason that you were in, thank you, Spirit, the reason that you were in the dream time to begin with. So there's a lot of ways to interpret that. My guides are saying it's okay. They're calling it a pronouncement. It's okay to imagine or assume that part of this soul journey, this circuit on your soul's trajectory, the dream time is this lifetime. You're here to finish something, some very beautiful mystical process. I have no doubt in my mind because of the way the cards have come out and how they relate to each other, which reminds me, please check the community tab after you're done watching the reading. I will post a picture of the cards there so you can see the full spread and just peer into it. and let it blow your mind the way it's blowing my mind. So I think, hang on a second. I left my bowl of runes way over there. Just bear with me for a sec while I grab them. And we're gonna go and have some time with the sacred bowl. Which, in case you didn't know, if you're new, that's why I have this. Somebody literally gave it to me probably 40 years ago or more. I think 45 years ago. My sister, who's an artist, went to an art show in the summertime and came home and said, I bought this for you, honey, because I don't know why, but I looked at it and I just knew it was yours. A little bit of foreshadowing. So let's go to the bowl. For beautiful Scorpio, can you please, Spirit, from the Norse tradition, give us a little more information. Whatever Scorpio needs to know. Okay. So, interesting. Here's what came out. I'm holding it upside down. That's the rune for opening. It's about bringing light into your life, flowing into your new position, being able to have a place of understanding that's new to you. If you're involved in any kind of a relationship that's been having challenges, it's a prophecy that says that period will be ending now. And then this came with it. Very interesting. So let's look into the book a little bit. If you're new and you don't know, I use the Book of Runes by Ralph Blum. Get yourself a copy on Amazon. It's phenomenal. And you get this beautiful little set of runes, okay? So this is about possessions. And basically the story about this is reflecting the reading. It's a moment when you have to decide, or you have the option to decide, what is most important to you? Possessions? Or the possession of your will and your ability to make your choices in your life. So I think I'm just going to leave that as it is, my guides are saying. And I'm going to read to you a little bit about the rune of opening. Because it's, my guides are saying, because it's cheerful. I like that. So opening, fire, the torch. This is the rune Kano. It's this rune brings opening and renewed clarity, dispelling the darkness like this. Thank you, Spirit. Dispelling the darkness that has been shrouding some part of your life. You are now free to both receive gifts and know the joy of non-attached giving. Kano is the rune for the morning of activities, for seriousness, clear intent, and concentration, all of which are essential at the beginning of any endeavor. Thank you so much. That's why they wanted me to read it, because they're talking about a brand new soul journey. The Fool card. I like it. Stepping off into the light. One of the 13 cycle runes, the protection of Kano is this. The more light you have, the better you can see what is trivial and outmoded in your own conditioning. In relationships, there can now be a mutual opening up, which you might trigger and set in motion through your awareness that the light of understanding is once again available to you both. Recognize that while on the one hand you may be limited and dependent, on the other, you exist at the perfect center where the harmonious and beneficent forces of the universe merge and radiate. Because you, Scorpio, are that center. That's what I was trying to say. The book says it in a way that I like better. There you are, my darlings. You mystical, mystical beings. What a sacrifice to come here and be on the earth. Thank you, by the way. We need you here. Obviously. Simply put, if you've been operating in the dark, there's now enough light to see that the patient on the operating table is you. So witness yourself, witness this gorgeous journey. Please leave some messages for all of us. What is your experience? What's going on for you? What's coming through to you? It's going to help us all to know. I appreciate everything that you teach me, Scorpio. So thank you so much for being here to pick up your messages. Goddess willing, I think I will be still on the road in August. I'm going to try to get the readings out a little bit early because I need to travel and have some fun on my new journey. Thanks, everybody.